Hello friends, welcome to TechStudySell. In this video, we'll make a very useful Alexa home automation system using the NodeMCU and Arduino IoT Cloud. To make this project, you just need a NodeMCU and a relay module, so you don't need any custom design PCB for this project, and you also don't need any Alexa device like Echo Dot. You can just use the Amazon Alexa app to control the relay with Alexa. Now before going to the details, let me show you how this Alexa home automation system works. Alexa, turn on switch 1. Alexa, turn on switch 4. Alexa, turn off switch 1. And I can also control it manually from the Amazon Alexa app. So here you can see I can easily control the switches from the Amazon Alexa app. Now let me control it manually. You can see I can also control it manually from this push button. Now let me turn off the Wi-Fi and show you how it works without internet. After turning off the Wi-Fi, the blue LED turns off automatically, which indicates now the NodeMCU is not connected with the internet. So I can control these appliances only from this push button. So let me control it from the push button. So if there is no internet, still we can control the appliances manually from the push button. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. So after turning on the Wi-Fi, you can see the NodeMCU automatically connect with the Wi-Fi and blue LED turns on. So I can again control these lamps with Alexa. Alexa, turn off switch 1. And you can also use Arduino IoT Cloud app to control these appliances. Let me show you. Let me turn off the lamp from this app. So this is a very useful home automation project, and during the video I will share the circuit, code and all other details. So I will highly recommend you to watch complete video, and after that you can easily make this project for your home. So let's get started. To make this home automation project, you need a NodeMCU, a 4-channel relay module and the push buttons. Now we have to connect all this component as per this circuit diagram. You can see in the circuit I have given the 5-volt supply to NodeMCU and the relay module, and these push buttons are connected across the GPIO pin and the ground pin. And this is the AC circuit. Please take proper safety precaution while connecting these 4 lamps with the relay module. As you can see, there are a lot of connections, so to make the circuit compact, I have designed a PCB for this project. But as I said, you can also make this project without using any custom design PCB. Still, if you want to get this custom design PCB, then download the GABA file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with 3 simple steps. First, upload the GABA file. Then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color. Then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the components required for the PCB. Now I will quickly solder all the components on the PCB. Now let me connect the NodeMCU with the PCB. Now I will configure the Arduino IoT Cloud. For that I have to connect the NodeMCU with my laptop. This is the code for this project. You can download this code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description, then you can download the code from this button. In the code, you have to enter some details from Arduino IoT Cloud. So before programming the NodeMCU, you have to configure the Arduino IoT Cloud. So you have to visit this page, then click here to create an account. Here I will click create one, give my birthday. Now here you have to enter the email ID, username and set a password for this account. Then click on sign up. Now here I will use free plan, and here you can see this is their free plan. We can create 2 things, unlimited dashboard. So this plan is sufficient to create this project, so we don't have to buy any paid plan here. Now I will click on IoT Cloud, then click on create things. Now here they have sent a verification code to the mail ID to activate the account. So let me go to my Gmail account. Here you can see this is the authentication email. I have to click here to activate the account. Now again I will go to the Arduino IoT Cloud, refresh the screen. First I have to select a device as NodeMCU, so I will click here and select the setup third party device, and I will check this ESP8266 and select the model as NodeMCU 1.0 and click on continue. Now I have to give a name to this device. You can give any name, so I am giving this name to this device. Now click on next. So it will generate a device ID and a secret key. You have to download that in PDF. So I will click here to download the device ID and secret key. Then I will click on continue. You can see our device added. Now I will click on this add variable button. As I am going to control 4 relay, so I will create 4 variables. So here I will give the name for the first variable as switch 1. You can give any name. Now here I will select Alexa compatible, and I will select this is a switch. You can also select light if you want. After that, the variable permission should be read write, and variable update policy will be selected as on change. Now I will click on add variable. So our first variable is created. In similar way, I have to create next 3 variables. As you can see, I have created all the 4 variables for the 4 relay, and I have given the name as switch 1, switch 2, switch 3 and switch 4. So Alexa will identify that particular switch with this name. Now after creating this variable, we will click on the dashboard, and here click on the build dashboard. Now here you have to click on this edit icon, and let me give the name of the dashboard. Now click on add, and here select the switch. Now I will use the first switch to control the relay 1. So here I will give the name switch 1, and I will link the variable with the switch 1 which we have created earlier. Now click on link variable. Now I have to click on done. So thus we have created the first switch in the dashboard. So thus you have to create 4 switch and link the switch with the variable created earlier. So you can see we have created our dashboard in the Arduino IoT Cloud. Now again I will click on things, select the things we have created just now. Now I will go to the sketch section. Now here you can see this sketch is automatically created, and whenever any change happened to switch 1, then what should happen, we have to enter here. So we will not update this sketch, we will use the sketch which you have downloaded. So from this Arduino IoT Cloud we will get the device ID. You can see this is the device ID. I will click here to copy the device ID. Now go to the Arduino sketch, and in the things property you have to enter the device ID. So I will enter the device ID here. Now I will copy the things ID. Here you can see this is the things ID at the bottom. I will enter the things ID here. Now in the Arduino secret you have to enter the Wi-Fi credential and the device key which we have downloaded in the PDF form. So let me enter the Wi-Fi credential. Now let me open the PDF which you have downloaded, and here you can see this is the secret ID. So we have entered the Wi-Fi credential, device key which is a secret key, and in the things property we have entered the things ID and device ID. After entering all these details, we need this Arduino IoT Cloud library. So I will go to sketch, then go to include library, manage libraries, and you have to install this Arduino IoT Cloud library. I have already installed it. Now when you click on install, it will ask to install all other dependency. So here you have to click on install all to install all the dependencies. So after installing all the libraries, we will go to tools, select the board as NodeMCU 1.0 and a proper port, then we can hit the upload button. After programming the NodeMCU, you can see the blue LED turns on, which indicate now the NodeMCU is connected with the Wi-Fi. So you can configure the Amazon Alexa app. Let me open the Amazon Alexa app. Let me first tap on the device, and here you can see no device connected. Now I will tap on more, select skills and games. Here I have to search for Arduino, tap on the Arduino. Now select the first option. Now tap on enable to use. It may ask for the Arduino IoT Cloud credential, so give the credential. After that you will find Arduino has been successfully linked. Now again I have to go to the Amazon Alexa app and select discover devices. Now Alexa is looking for the new device, and during this time the NodeMCU should be connected with the Wi-Fi. And here you can see 4 devices found. So again I will go to device, and in the switches you will get all these 4 devices. I can also control it from the Amazon Alexa app. As you can see, I have connected all these 4 lamps with the relay module as per the circuit. Now let me turn on the supply. Alexa, turn on switch 1. Alexa, turn on switch 4. And you can also join our Telegram channel Tech Study Cell to get more such home automation ideas. If you find this project helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.